everyone. Today, we'll learn about the sequence in the series, the difference of these two, the common types of the sequence, and of course, we're going to solve some problems regarding the sequence. Let's start. What is a sequence? A sequence is defined as an arrangement of numbers in particular order. This order could be in arithmetic order or geometric order, but we also have harmonic and a Fibonacci. Now, on the other hand, a series is defined as the sum of the elements of a sequence. So technically, when you say sum, you will see a plus symbol. Let's try now to identify if a given term is a sequence or a series. Let's take a look on our example. Number 1, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. There is an arrangement of numbers in a particular order. And this order is in arithmetic sequence. And we will talk about the arithmetic later on. So this is a sequence. Number 2, 1 plus 1 over 3 plus 1 over 9 plus 1 over 27. Of course, you see a plus symbol, automatic, this is a series. And number 3, you're given 1, 1, 2, 3, 5, 8, 13, and so on. Look at the sequence. The sequence in which each element is obtained by adding two preceding elements is what you call a Fibonacci. 1 plus 1 is 2. 1 plus 2 is 3. 2 plus 3 is 5. 3 plus 5 is 8. And so on. So this is in an order of Fibonacci. A sequence. Let's talk about the common types of a sequence. The arithmetic sequence and the geometric sequence. Arithmetic sequence is a sequence where each succeeding term is obtained by adding or subtracting a fixed number. This fixed number is what we call a common difference. And we will be needing the following formula. So, an equals a1 plus n minus 1 times d, where an is your last term, A1 is your first term, N is the number of terms, and D is the common difference. Let's proceed with the geometric sequence. A geometric sequence is a sequence where each succeeding term is obtained by multiplying or dividing a fixed number. And this fixed number is what we call a common ratio. So we will be needing this formula. So we have an equals a1 times r to the power of n minus 1, where an is your last term, a1 is your first term, r is your common ratio, and n is the number of terms. Let's have our first example. How many terms are there in an arithmetic sequence with first term is 5, a common difference of negative 3, and the last term of negative 76? Let's try to write the given first. So, how to solve this problem? You are to find the number of terms or the n. So the number of terms is 28. By using this formula, we plug in all the data that is given. 5 for the first term, the last term is negative 76, and a common difference of negative 3. So you do some basic algebra, you distribute negative 3 times n, negative 3 times negative 1, and then odd 5 and 3, 8, plus negative 3n equals negative 76. We have to subtract 8 on both sides. Minus 8 will cancel out. And minus 8, negative 84. Then divide both sides by negative 3, so we have 28. Example number 2. List the first 3 terms of arithmetic sequence if the 25th term is 35 and the 30th term is 5. So we have to write the given first. Given the 30th term is 5 and the 25th term is 35, we are to find the first 3 terms. So that is A1, A2, and A3. We have to solve all of this. So now, we don't have any common difference here. So we have to find out what is the common difference. So this is how I do it. Given the 25th term, we don't have the 26th, 27th, 28th, 29th, given the 30th term to be 5. So I will let the 35 to be the first number and the number 5 to be the 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, the 6th term. The number of terms, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And find the common difference. So our common difference is negative 6. We have solved D, or the common difference, to be negative 6, so we can use it and apply in our general formula. A25 is 35. So A1 is 179. A2, since we have a common difference of negative 6, a decreasing order, so minus 6 is 173, and then another minus 6 is 167. So we have A1, A2, and A3. Example number 3. Find the sum of all positive 3-digit odd integers. So you have to think of this 3-digit odd integers. Given the first 3-digit odd integers is 101, and the last is 999. So we can now add all the numbers from 101 up to 999 using this formula. The sum of the numbers in an arithmetic sequence is given by this formula, n over 2 times a1 plus the last term. We're given the first term and the last term, but we don't have the number of terms. So we have to find the number of terms by using our general formula. An, first term, the number of terms is missing, and a common difference of 101 is the first term, the next term is 103, the next term is 105, we have a common difference of 2. So we have solved the number of terms to be 450. So we can use this now and plug it in our formula. And that is the sum of terms. Example number 4. Given the geometric sequence 1 over 2, 1 over 4, 1 over 8, and so on, find the 9th term. So let's try to find the given first. The common ratio can be solved by dividing or finding the quotient of the 2nd term over the 1st term, the 3rd term over the 2nd term, the 4th term over the 3rd term. That's how you get the common ratio. So in this case, 1/4 divided by 1/2 is 1/2. That is your common ratio. Again, you just have to divide the 2nd term by the 1st term, or 3rd term by the 2nd term, or 4th term by the 3rd term. That's how you get the common ratio. So using this formula, we can find the 9th term. So that is the 9th term, 1 over 512. Just plug in all the data in your formula. The first term is 1 half, the common ratio, 1 half, and then n is the ninth term, minus 1, becomes 8, and then manipulate it, you can get, you solve a9 to be 1 over 512. Finally, the last example. The fifth term of a geometric sequence is 16, and the eighth term is 128. Find the first term. Let's find the given first. Given these two, let's find the first term. Let 16 to be your first term, and let 128 is your fourth term. We have solved R to be 2. So we can find now the first term given this R is 2 and the fifth term. So we have solved the first term to be equal to 1. Thank you.